education, partnerships, innovation, progress, excellence, a decade of delivery and transformation. This is the story of the Buffalo Public Schools Renovation Program.
The world is changing so rapidly, young people, with the technology and all the communication systems that we have, so we have to upgrade our toolboxes sometimes every week. And you're going to have to do the same thing, young people, because you're part of this world. You're part of this world. And you're going to have to read and do research and keep up with what's going on in the world to make sure you have the right tools to deal with knowledge and thinking in your toolbox.
Today we are preparing and building our future.
Hi, I'm Tracy Cardwell from LPCiminelli and the host of the Buffalo Public Schools Renovation Program, Making It Happen. Right now I'm standing outside of Buffalo Public School number 198, International Preparatory School at Grover, Cleveland, where they just held their final ribbon cutting ceremony on September 29, 2014. This ribbon cutting ceremony represented the 48th and final school reopening of the Buffalo Public Schools Renovation Program. Now that included 5 district-wide technology projects, 5 energy performance projects,
and $1.3 billion in renovations and construction.
Now we've been talking about making it happen for the past 10 years. And in this documentary, we're gonna go back to day one and talk about how we made it happen in this very unique program. Now when I say we, I mean New York State, the City of Buffalo, Buffalo Public School District, and LPCiminelli in a very unique partnership. In 2003, a collaboration between the Buffalo Public Schools and LPCiminelli marked the beginning of the most comprehensive school reconstruction program in Buffalo's history. This program's lofty goal was to completely transform the facilities of the Buffalo Public School District into 21st century learning centers of excellence. A decade ago, the declining infrastructure of the Buffalo Public Schools had become a major issue. Buildings averaged 70 years of age and most facilities were in need of significant upgrades. Classrooms were not designed for modern learning. Technology was limited or non-existent. The dire situation led local and state leaders to begin planning for a comprehensive district-wide program to modernize Buffalo schools and right-size the district based on current and future enrollment needs. From these planning efforts arose the idea of a joint schools construction board.
It really started with Arthur Eve and was carried on by Paul Tokas. We came up with this whole concept of the joint schools construction project, where it was really state-of-the-art and first of its kind program really in the country, where, as you know, because LPCiminelli has been at this from the very beginning, it was a program where the state would reimburse the city and the school district nearly 100%, you know, mid-90s, for every dollar invested in reconstructing and rehabilitating the Buffalo Public Schools.
When state legislation was passed in 2001 to make the JSCB a reality, a truly unique program was born. The Joint Schools Construction Board, comprised of representatives from the City of Buffalo and the Buffalo Board of Education, began looking to hire a program manager. They needed a company that could handle the monumental task presented and to do so in a way that wouldn't impact the local tax base. Ultimately, the JSCB selected LPCiminelli and its team of nationally recognized firms to fulfill this mission.
While state aid accounted for the vast majority of program funding, the balance would typically be borne by city taxpayers, which is commonly referred to as local share. But as part of LPCiminelli's proposal, several innovative financing mechanisms were developed to cover the local share. This ultimately meant the reconstruction program did not place any added burden on Buffalo property taxpayers. Now, the strategic approach taken to transform the district schools into centers of excellence required well-measured construction phasing over a 10-year period. So within those 10 years, 5 construction phases for 48 schools were completed. 5 district-wide technology and 5 energy performance projects were completed. A massive undertaking totaling $1.3 billion.
The team at LPCiminelli assumed ultimate responsibility for all work, mitigating any design omissions and errors at no cost to the district. In addition to managing designers and contractors to deliver over $1 billion in construction, we were responsible for managing legislation, financing, community outreach, MWBE development and mentoring, curriculum enrichment, and community relations.
While reconstruction scope varied and was tailored to each school's specific needs, there were many elements held in common. Due to age, condition, exposure to various elements, and deferred maintenance, many of the schools suffered from the following issues that were corrected through the reconstruction program. Deteriorated, single-pane, uninsulated wood windows, many of which contained yellowed plastic replacement panes. Old, uninsulated roofing that leaked. Masonry walls in need of repointing that allowed water infiltration to interior spaces, causing plaster damage. Unstable chimneys that were in danger of collapsing. Old coal bunkers that leaked. Old inefficient boilers covered with asbestos insulation. Outdated or non-existent mechanical control systems. Deactivated inoperable ventilation fans and ventilation tunnels that became dumping grounds over the years. The schools lacked fresh air. Antiquated electrical systems. Asbestos-containing materials throughout the schools found in floor tile and mastics, ceiling tile mastic, on pipe insulation, and in crawl spaces.
Leaking underground oil storage tanks, PCBs in abandoned transformers and in building caulk, lead paint, old inefficient lighting, lack of handicapped accessibility at building entrances, throughout the building due to changes in elevation and the lack of ramps and elevators. Toilet rooms and fixtures. Auditoriums. Lockers and drinking fountains. Outdated classroom technology and inappropriate space for computer classrooms, science labs, home and career rooms. Lack of data in the classrooms. No dedicated space for student computer workstations. Inappropriate program spaces, cafeterias that were created by taking classroom space, inappropriate special education pullout space, inappropriate non-compliant health clinic space. Gymnasiums were outdated, worn, lacked modern amenities, and contained dangerous gym divider doors that were banned by the State Education Department. Auditoriums were outdated and seats were in bad condition. Exit stairs were open to corridors, which was a serious life safety concern. What's so exciting about this historic program for our region is the attention given to every detail. The district-wide technology project provides students and teachers state-of-the-art 21st century classrooms, complete with touch-sensitive whiteboards.
The scope of this initiative includes a district-wide telephone system, as well as data cabling, new modern telecommunications wiring in every building, computer system technology, and extensive surveillance monitoring and security systems. To provide the district efficient, cost-effective server virtualization, 2 district network operation centers were also included in the district-wide technology project. When setting out to create learning centers of excellence, environmental impact was taken into consideration. This is why energy performance projects were built into the Buffalo Schools program to promote energy efficiency throughout the district. The District Energy Performance Project features improvements to district lighting, temperature control systems, energy efficient motor systems, new steam traps, pool covers, and building envelope, all designed to keep students and teachers comfortable throughout the school day. Phase 1 of the Buffalo Public School program laid the groundwork for the phases that would follow. Although the focus of the program was the renovation of 9 school buildings, this $173 million phase featured initiatives that would become hallmarks of the program. These initiatives include the inclusion of local MWBEs, curriculum-enriched programs for Buffalo Public School students, safety partnerships, energy performance measures, technology initiatives, and innovative rebuilding efforts.
Native American Magnet School No. 19 serves grades pre-K through 8. Reconstruction work is highlighted by a courtyard cafeteria addition, new playground, and windows. Handicap access was enhanced with the installation of a new elevator, as well as other Americans with Disabilities Act, or ADA, upgrades. New mechanical, electrical, and plumbing, or MEP, systems were installed throughout the school, and new finishes feature a Native American cultural theme.
School 31 Harriet Ross Tubman serves grades pre-K through 8, was the first K through 12 pilot leadership in energy and environmental design for existing buildings project in the nation. Reconstruction work included a new insulated white roof, extensive masonry restoration and new windows. Interior improvements included updated MEP systems, an energy-saving pool cover, reconstructed auditorium, and state-of-the-art classrooms with new millwork, countertops, and sinks.
Public School No. 38, Frank A. Sedita Academy, serves grades pre-K through 8. Many of the interior walls were demolished and the floor plan was altered to better serve the academic program needs. Reconstruction work included new windows, new computer rooms, a new art classroom, and a small locker room addition. New secure entrances were created and interior systems and finishes were upgraded.
Public School 66, North Park Middle Academy, accommodates grades 5 through 8. Extensive interior demolition allowed for the installation of new MEP systems, a new elevator, and other needed ADA improvements. The gym was renovated and the existing floor was replaced. New interior spaces include science and computer labs, a media center, art room, and a home and careers classroom.
School number 67, the Discovery School, serves grades pre-K through 8. Creative design resulted in a very dynamic transformation of this school. The existing ground level courtyard space was demolished and an addition was created through the installation of a unique fabric roof. Consistent with the Discovery School theme, mechanical systems as well as the mechanisms of the new elevator are left exposed. With 2 newly constructed balconies overlooking the mezzanine and ground levels, the new courtyard is a focal point of the school. Newly created spaces include the cafeteria, library, technology lab, and computer rooms.
Buffalo Public School 74 Hamlin Park School serves grades pre-K through 8. Phase 1 of the project created a 3-story addition featuring 20 classrooms, a new library, technology classroom, and a computer room. Subsequent Phase 2 reconstruction work included the installation of new windows, a new ADA-compliant elevator, MEP systems, and finishes throughout the original school.
Like other reconstruction schools, Highgate Heights School No. 80 features a newly constructed, identifiable, secure main entrance. Creative design allowed for 2 large additions to be constructed while maintaining the historic nature of this school. Selective demolition paved the way for a new cafeteria addition that was built over the existing gym. A classroom addition was built over the existing auditorium. 2 new elevators were installed and program spaces throughout the school enjoy new MEP systems and finishes. Exterior windows and skylights were restored and new brickwork mimics the existing diaper patterning seen on several Buffalo schools. BPS number 80 serves pre-K through 8.
Harvey Austin School 97 serves grades pre-K through 8. Intensive interior demolition and reconstruction was required to accommodate this new program. Site work included the removal of a large underground oil storage tank and the installation of new sidewalks and paving. A small addition was built to house a boys' locker room and weight room. New light fixtures were installed throughout the school. Existing skylights integral to the building's unique sawtooth roof were replaced. Interior finish upgrades include terrazzo-style floor tile in the corridors and new lockers. A new wood floor was installed in the gym, along with new bleachers, wall pads, and retractable basketball backboards.
East High School number 307 served grades 9 through 12. Interior courtyard demolition allowed for the installation of new structural steel to support a new expanded cafeteria and study hall. The new cafeteria features a food court type of layout. All windows were replaced. Intensive interior reconstruction included heavy gut demolition, the installation of new MEP systems and finishes throughout the school. Areas of highlight include the cafeteria, classrooms, lab spaces, gymnasium, and even corridors and toilet rooms. Music rooms were enhanced with acoustical panels and instrument storage spaces, and the stunning auditorium features a brand new theatrical lighting system.
After completing the award-winning Phase 1, no time was wasted in starting Phase 2. Totaling roughly $327 million, this phase involved renovations to 13 schools and one athletic stadium. Nearly 400 subcontractors and consultants worked on this phase, renovating a total of 1.7 million square feet of educational space. An additional 195,000 square feet of new educational space was constructed for the students that attend the Phase 2 schools. All 13 facilities were renovated and turned over to the district by September 2007.
Buffalo Public School Number 6, the Buffalo Elementary School of Technology, accommodates pre-K through 8th grade students. Reconstruction included the demolition of an unsightly temporary classroom structure. Interior gut demolition allowed for the installation of new MEP systems and architectural finishes throughout the school. Consistent with other schools, the auditorium seats were refurbished and saw the installation of code-compliant seat uplift mechanisms. All exterior doors and windows were replaced with energy-efficient insulated glass units.
School 33, the Bilingual Center, is a pre-K through 8 school. A new 29,000 square foot addition featuring classrooms, an appropriately sized gym, and new administrative space was constructed to complement the existing school. An interior courtyard allowing for safe outdoor play was created on this limited site. A new secure student and faculty entrance was created and MEP systems were upgraded. New finishes were installed throughout the school.
Marva J. Daniels Futures Preparatory School number 37 accommodates grades pre-K through 8. The project scope included interior and exterior renovations of the existing building, a children's courtyard, historic window restoration, and extensive exterior masonry work, particularly at the parapet level. MEP systems were upgraded and existing lockers were refurbished, as was ornate interior woodwork.
Martin Luther King Multicultural Institute School number 39 project scope included the renovation of the existing three-story building and the construction of a two-story addition. The addition, totaling more than 27,000 square feet, includes a new cafeteria, library, classrooms, restrooms, and additional administrative space. By adding the new space to the building's south side, an outdoor courtyard was created at the center of the complex. The new layout of the facility allows the district to rearrange classes within the building so grade levels are more logically grouped. The new building plan accommodates pre-K through 8th grade.
The Houghton Academy School No. 69 project included the demolition of a temporary classroom facility annex and the construction of a new three-story 22,500 square foot addition in its place. The addition includes several new classrooms and large instructional spaces. New skylights were installed over the gym, flooding it with natural light. The new building plan expanded the student population to accommodate pre-K through 8th grades.
At the historic Early Childhood Center School No. 82, renovations included extensive exterior envelope work, new roof, new windows and doors, and extensive masonry work. On the interior, walls were reconfigured to allow for logical grade level groupings. The new learning environments benefit from MEP upgrades, ADA improvements, and new finishes. New color and patterning in finishes help students with wayfinding. The new building plan accommodates pre-K through 4th grade.
Buffalo Public School No. 90, the Dr. Charles Drew Science Magnet Early Childhood Center, accommodates pre-K through 2nd grade. The project scope included the renovation of the existing one-story school, the construction of a new secure main entrance, and the construction of a one-story addition. The renovation area and addition houses new and expanded classrooms, a new media center, administrative spaces, and a community clinic. Of most distinction, however, is the curriculum-based interior courtyard that was created. Every element in this courtyard is designed for multiple uses and encourages interaction between students and nature. This setting allows children access to natural elements that are not found in this urban location of the city.
The Build Academy School No. 91 renovations included the reconstruction of the existing two-story building and the construction of three small additions. Reconstruction work included interior gut demolition, new roofing, and new windows. The additions include new classrooms, storage rooms, an auditorium lobby, a health suite, and an elevator. This expanded building plan, which accommodates pre-K through 8th grade, provided the district with enough space to merge students from Public School No. 11 and Public School No. 91 into one building.
The West Hurdle School No. 94 is a 188,700 square foot structure constructed in 1968. The project scope included the renovation of the existing building, the relocation of the main office to allow direct supervision of the main building entrance, as well as a new student bus drop-off. Exterior improvements made the building more energy efficient. The new building plan expanded the student population, which formerly accommodated grades 5 through 8, to accommodate pre-K through 8th grades.
School No. 95, Waterfront Elementary, serves pre-K through 8th. The project scope included the renovation of the existing building, the construction of a two-story classroom addition, and the construction of a new front entry. The reconstructed school floor plan accommodates an increased school enrollment and converts the learning space from an open-plan classroom concept to a traditional floor plan.
Built on the site where Offerman Stadium once stood, this school was transformed into School No. 192, the Buffalo Academy for Visual and Performing Arts, through the reconstruction program. The project scope included the complete reconstruction of the existing building, systems and finishes, selective demolition to allow for the construction of two-story classroom additions, and the construction of a performing arts addition. The new classroom additions house science labs and art studios. The performing arts addition houses a state-of-the-art performance hall, a smaller black box theater, and several instrumental music rooms. The performance hall contains professional quality lighting and sound systems, both of which are of the caliber to mount Broadway productions. The new building plan accommodates grades 5 through 12.
Bennett High School No. 200 and All High Stadium share a site in North Buffalo. The school project scope included the reconstruction of the existing building, while new work included the construction of 2 3-story classroom wings. The additions increased the school's program space by 30,000 square feet. The building's additions and reconstruction work were carefully designed to complement the historic architecture of this classical structure. The stadium project scope included the complete demolition of the north and east concrete bleacher sections, extensive renovation of the remainder of the facility, and the installation of new seating. Site work included a new synthetic surface running track, field turf, lighting, utilities, paving, landscaping, and fencing. The new building accommodates grades 9 through 12, while the stadium hosts district-wide and regional sporting events. Built in 1914, Hutchinson Central Technical High School No. 304 is recognized as a downtown Buffalo landmark. Demolition of an undersized gym allowed for a very creative yet challenging design to be constructed. New structural steel, masts, support box trusses to span what would become a state-of-the-art gym. 8 new classrooms are housed in the 2 stories that are suspended above the new gym. In response to historic preservation concerns, the addition sits apart from the existing school, and the void between the two is covered with a translucent skylight. Heavy gut renovation on the interior allowed for the relocation of the cafeteria from the 4th floor down to the ground floor. Upper floors of the school were reconstructed to accommodate upgraded shop spaces, labs, classrooms, and the library. Appropriately, the auditorium was restored to its original grandeur.
7 of the 9 schools included in this $350 million phase of construction were completed in 2009. The remaining 2 schools were completed in 2010. Close to 350 construction companies have renovated over 1.2 million square feet of educational space. In addition, roughly 337,000 square feet of new educational space have been constructed for the students that have attended these newly renovated schools.
Hillary Park Elementary School No. 27 accommodates grades pre-K through 8. The design called for selective demolition to allow for a new layout for the school, bus loop, parking areas, and handicapped access to a new main entrance. A large 2-story classroom addition was constructed, and the existing cafeteria was expanded to accommodate more students. 2 new science labs were created, each featuring 8 lab stations. Reconstruction scope included new roof, new windows, new MEP systems, ADA improvements, and new finishes throughout. Like most reconstruction schools, School No. 32, Bennett Park Montessori, work began with selective demolition and the abatement of hazardous materials throughout the existing building. Next, site work and foundation work was completed, followed by the erection of structural steel for the large classroom and gymnasium addition. New handicapped entrances were installed and a new boiler room was added to the facility, and the school's temperature control system was updated with the addition of 2 new boilers. Extensive landscaping work was performed to the school grounds, featuring limestone sidewalks and a large garden. The finished facility, which accommodates pre-K through 8th grade, provided the district with enough space to merge students from School 78 and School 32 into one building.
Originally built in 1890, the Lovejoy Discovery School No. 43 is one of the oldest schools in the Buffalo school system. Extensive reconstruction was required to address several code-related life safety issues that existed, and a 50,000 square foot addition was constructed. The addition houses classroom space and administrative offices. Other renovations include updates to the auditorium, new finishes applied to all floors and ceilings, a new boiler system, and an updated security system featuring over 120 security cameras. The gymnasium was completely renovated, and an elevator was added to the building. The school accommodates pre-K through 8th grade.
School No. 45, the international school, was challenged by the need to abate asbestos containing spray-on fireproofing that was on structural steel throughout the school. Renovations included brand new windows, a new temperature control system, new boilers, new ceilings and floors, new cabinetry, new handicapped access ramps, and refurbished lockers. The school auditorium was updated with all seats refurbished. The building layout was reconfigured to increase efficiency and modernize the learning environment. A new two-story addition was constructed to provide new classroom space. The renovated school accommodates kindergarten through eighth grade.
Careful thought and planning went into the design of the addition at the 1927 Buffalo School No. 76, Herman Badillo Bilingual Academy. Every effort was made to conserve already limited parking and maximize green space while allowing for a large addition to be constructed, merging students from BPS No. 36 and 76 into one pre-K through 8 school. Selective demolition allowed for the new 38,000 square foot addition to be built. The three-story addition includes a new secure main entrance, several classrooms, a new kitchen and cafeteria, library and computer classroom. Respecting the context of the surrounding historic West Elmwood Village neighborhood, the design of the exterior reflects the design sensibility of adjacent homes. Reconstruction of the existing facility included new science labs, new music rooms, new skylights, and an updated technology shop with new machinery. Renovations consistent with other schools were made to the gymnasium, auditorium, and other program spaces.
Listed on the National Register of Historic Buildings, City Honors School No. 195 accommodates grades 5 through 12. The scope of work includes the construction of two new additions, one of which is a 12,000 square foot natatorium that is used for district-wide swim meets. The natatorium features an 8-lane competitive swimming pool, 1-meter diving boards and bleachers for spectators. The second addition houses the new gymnasium, library, 4 computer labs, and several science labs. The gym addition is connected to the original facility by a 2-story suspended walkway encased in glass curtain wall construction. The existing cafeteria was expanded with increased seating room to also serve as a study hall. The cafeteria space extends through a repurposed corridor into an addition which links the gym and pool. New MEP systems, new windows, partial roofing work, and interior finishes were completed in this historic school.
A sports pavilion addition was constructed adjacent to the 1928 Riverside Institute of Technology School No. 205. The pavilion overlooks brand new athletic fields with new synthetic turf. New locker rooms, coaching staff offices, a weight room, press box, new stadium seating, and stadium lighting allow for district-wide sporting events. Reconstruction scope included new windows, upgraded heating and ventilation systems, new lighting systems, and finishes. The pool was renovated and the gymnasium received many new amenities. The auditorium's wood stage was refinished and seats were repaired and refurbished. An existing courtyard was enclosed to create an auxiliary cafeteria under a cow wall roof system. The school accommodates grades 9 through 12.
South Park High School No. 206 renovations include the demolition of the existing undersized gymnasium and the construction of a new 2-story addition in its place. The new addition includes a gymnasium, locker rooms, a fitness room, and several classrooms. The addition was built adjacent to the school's existing pool. Additional renovations were performed throughout the existing facility, updating and modernizing all classrooms. The auditorium was completely renovated. The floor plan of the school was reconfigured to increase efficiency, and brand new equipment and technology was installed in all shops, labs, and classrooms. The renovated and expanded facility accommodates grades 9 through 12.
The unique vocational programs at Burghardt High School No. 301 made it impractical to relocate students to a swing school during construction. As a result, reconstruction of the school was completed while students occupied the facility. Temporary partitions separated students from active construction areas, and work was scheduled to minimize disruption to students. Reconstruction work included invasive exterior work to replace deteriorated concrete, exterior brickwork reconstruction at the iconic tower and at the parapet level took place to recreate the original basket weave patterning. New windows were installed. A striking new entrance addition signaling a new image for a school was built. The addition houses administrative space, an expanded library, and a virtual enterprise classroom with distance learning capabilities. Renovations to the existing facility include extensive upgrades to all vocational shops and labs. The facility accommodates grades 9 through 12.
Phase 4 construction started in the fourth quarter of 2009 and included the reconstruction of 10 schools and two district-wide projects with a total value of $292 million. Five of the 10 schools were completed in 2011, and the remaining five schools were completed in 2012. Buffalo Public School No. 3 DeUville Porter reconstruction included chimney stabilization and building envelope repairs, including masonry restoration, roofing, copper coping, and flashing repair. Building systems were upgraded and the interior spaces were transformed dramatically. Alternating corridor finishes and colors help with wayfinding. The auditorium scope of work included the removal of a wall at the balcony level to allow for an increase in seating capacity. School number 3 accommodates grades pre-K through 8.
Serving grades pre-K through 4th, the Early Childhood Center School number 17 renovations includes the construction of two one-story additions. The first addition houses a new secure entrance, principal's office, and guidance counselor's offices. The second addition houses a new kitchen and cafeteria addition featuring large windows. The health suite was renovated and the library was expanded. A new roof, new windows, and new boilers were installed. Site renovations include a reconfigured and resurfaced parking lot, partial replacement of curbs and sidewalks, creation of retention walls, increased handicap accessibility, and a new playground.
Located on busy Main Street, the design of the Dr. George Blackman School of Excellence, number 54, sought to preserve parking, green space, and most importantly, a bus loop to take buses off the busy street. At the same time, spray-on fireproofing had to be abated throughout the school. An efficient, cost-effective design was needed. New windows, roofing, and boilers were installed. Existing spaces and systems were modernized. The existing cafeteria was relocated to the ground floor. A new playground was created on previously underutilized green space, and the parking lot was resurfaced at this pre-K through 4 school.
Buffalo Public School No. 72 Lorraine Academy reconstruction includes two additions. The first addition houses a suite of administrative offices and conference space. The second, a two-story courtyard addition, contains a brand new library featuring exquisite woodwork which carries a new courtyard theme indoors by creating seating and shelving that replicates a tree. This addition also includes classroom space on both floors and a computer lab. The finished school featured two science labs, one demolished and rebuilt, the other newly constructed. The home and careers room was completely renovated, receiving new casework and select fixtures. Extensive interior demolition was required to realize the final design. This school accommodates grades pre-K through 8.
Reconstruction for Buffalo Public School No. 81 focused predominantly on improving program spaces and building envelope upgrades. Interior demolition allowed for relocation of the cafeteria and kitchen to the ground floor. New insulated roofing and new windows were installed to improve energy efficiency, and masonry restoration was completed to prevent continued plaster damage through moisture infiltration. Numerous building systems were replaced with modern energy-saving systems. However, the most notable feature of the project is a large three-story classroom addition. The site renovations include a reconfigured parking lot and bus loop, a new playground, handicap accessibility was increased throughout the facility, and both a new elevator and wheelchair lift were installed. The renovated school serves pre-K through 8 grades. The Erie County Health Center for Children number 84 accommodates kindergarten through 12th grades and is a highly specialized school that's built adjacent to the Erie County Medical Center. The school's proximity to ECMC is highly beneficial to the student population, which includes children with severe disabilities. This school's renovation project upgraded classroom and therapy spaces and building systems. Handicapped accessibility has been increased in all areas. The combined cafeteria auditorium received upgrades, and a unique apartment classroom, which teaches life skills, was constructed. The gymnasium and natatorium received new amenities. Several health support facilities were renovated and modernized, including new equipment and lift systems. The main entrance to the school was improved through the demolition of a large obtrusive loading dock and the construction of an expanded interior vestibule and exterior canopy. The school's interior corridors were outfitted with unique wayfinding materials that provide clues to help students navigate the school.
Buffalo Public School number 93 Southside Elementary is a three-story elementary school that received upgrades to address windowless classrooms and inefficient building systems. New openings were created and windows and doors were installed to allow for pre-K and kindergarten students to access newly created exterior learning gardens. All interior systems and finishes were upgraded and boilers were replaced. The auditorium received new carpet and a new stage lighting system. The gymnasium received new amenities. Updates were made in the technology and art room, and the home and careers room received new casework and new fixtures. The school's exterior received a new entrance canopy and a new exterior courtyard, which featured new concrete pavers, decorative fencing, turf, sandboxes, and benches. School 93 serves students in grades pre-K through 8. The Math, Science, and Technology at Seneca School number 197 reconstruction project scope included two small but important additions. The first addition added a new stairway to address a pre-existing egress issue. The second addition was a second floor elevated corridor connecting two remote wings of the existing building. A new interior addition was created by demolishing a portion of the second floor to create a new dramatic expanded two-story library. This space features an atrium and new skylight. Interior renovations at the basement level included three new language arts classrooms, new restrooms, and a new technology lab. To improve classroom layout on the second floor, numerous partitions were removed and relocated, redistributing space among 18 classrooms while creating 5 labs, 2 art studios, and new faculty restrooms. Similar renovations were performed on the third floor, resulting in 6 new labs, 1 office, and 1 classroom. New windows and MEP systems were installed, and ADA improvements were made throughout the school. The design also encompassed an exterior natural environment facility, which was built adjacent to an indoor conservation classroom. School 197 accommodates grades 5 through 12. Constructed in 1935, the Olmsted at Kensington School number 203 is one of Buffalo's finest examples of Art Deco architecture. The existing structure is a mix of 3-story and 4-story wings framing a central tower crowned with copper. New windows and extensive masonry work was necessary to tighten the building envelope. The reconstruction project scope included the removal and construction of numerous partitions to evenly distribute the number of classrooms. Also of note was the removal of flooring at each level to allow for a new egress stair to be constructed to correct a life safety code egress issue. Serving students in grades 5 through 12, the school also received a 1-story cube-shaped music addition, which is adjacent to the beautifully renovated auditorium. The school grounds were completely reimagined, receiving landscaping both inspired by and paying tribute to Frederick Law Olmsted.
McKinley High School number 305 called for a new 20-classroom addition to complement the myriad of shop spaces and trades-related programs offered at this school. The dramatic four-story addition fronting on Elmwood Avenue features a green roof harvesting rainwater to promote sustainability. The rainwater is collected, filtered, and diverted to the nearby Skajakwita River. To support the horticultural program at this school, four existing greenhouses saw extensive reconstruction. Work included new glazing, HVAC, plumbing, electrical, and liquid fertilizer systems. All exterior windows were replaced and MEP systems were upgraded in this large school. The school auditorium received new seats, a new main curtain, and new lighting and sound systems. Program-related changes included an expanded library, and the cafeteria received larger windows and expanded seating capacity, while the kitchen received new serving lines and equipment upgrades. Two existing machine shops were repurposed. The first shop was split into two visual art studios, and the second shop became a new fitness room. Both instrumental and choral music classrooms were expanded and completely renovated during construction. A new courtyard was created in the center of the four-story addition. The courtyard is being used as an outdoor classroom where the study of horticulture, humanities, and science can be fully integrated. School 305 serves grades 9 through 12.
Construction in 2011 on Phase 5 included reconstruction of 7 schools and 2 district-wide projects with a total value of $175 million. 6 of the 7 schools were completed in 2013, and the remaining school and 2 district-wide projects were completed in 2014.
Two small additions were constructed at Dr. Antonia Pantoja Community School number 18, a main entrance addition and an enclosure for an emergency egress stair from the basement level. However, it was creative design that identified an interior location for a new 7-stop passenger elevator providing handicapped accessibility to all levels. Interior work included asbestos abatement, demolition of walls, ceilings, mechanical, and electrical systems. New program spaces included classrooms for technology education, a science lab, an art room, and a home and careers classroom. In the school's auditorium, light fixtures and seating were refurbished and the stage floor was refinished. New energy-efficient boilers were put in place, and on the exterior, a new roof and emergency egress windows were installed. 3 exterior canopies adorned with black enamel porcelain and stainless steel copings replicated to match the original design specifications at this impressive Art Deco style school. School number 18 serves grades pre-K through 8.
Buffalo Public Community School number 53 accommodates pre-K through 8th grades. Reconstruction focused on the creation of better program spaces both inside and outside the school. Demolition of an unsightly one-story concrete block classroom addition that was built in 1960 was the first order of business. Newfound green space allowed for the installation of a new playground in its place. A new 2-story, 7 classroom addition was constructed, creating an outdoor learning courtyard area. The courtyard included numerous different types of finishes, including synthetic turf, brick and concrete pavers, cast-in-place concrete, grass and amphitheater-type seating. The new addition exterior has a modern look with metal panels and brick with large windows to provide natural light to the interior spaces. Many of the spaces are unrecognizable from their previous appearance. The gym is a great example of this. Windows were replaced, new MEP systems were installed, and the image of the school is completely transformed while reestablishing its historic character.
The Charles Drew Science Magnet Museum School No. 59 was constructed in 1990 as an addition to the Buffalo Museum of Science. The museum and the school function independently, but share some common spaces and resources. The classroom space reconfiguration includes new partition installation that took the existing open plan teaching concept into a more traditional classroom environment. The existing library underwent extensive updating, which included new finishes, carpeting, paint, and casework. New computer workstations were added to the library. As part of the energy performance project, all heat pumps were replaced. Exterior alterations included a new outdoor teaching space, which features exhibits for students to have hands-on learning experiences. School number 59 accommodates grades 3-8.
School number 61, the Early Childhood Center, was built in 1904. The original building contains decorative tin ceilings that were restored during construction. In classrooms that contain these metal tiles, acoustic clouds were added to help regulate the acoustical quality of the rooms. A new addition was constructed to provide code-required egress from the auditorium and gym. An existing stairwell was removed to allow for expansion of the cafeteria, and the kitchen received all new equipment. Two elevators were added to provide access throughout the school. A new computer room was added on the ground floor, and each classroom received new student computer workstations and interactive boards. Exterior work included the construction of new entrance stairs and accessible ramps, repointing of masonry, replacement of windows, exterior doors, and roofing. This school serves students in grades pre-K through 4.
The Frederick Law Olmsted School No. 64 accommodates pre-K through 4th grade students. Through coordination with the State Historic Preservation Office, the architect was able to design a large 3-story classroom addition with minimal impact to the site while providing much needed new program space. A unique skylight that spans the entire length of the addition allows light to pass through the corridor glass block floors at the 2nd and 3rd floors and into the gymnasium and cafeteria spaces. An existing connecting corridor was reimagined and an outdoor plaza was created to link the pre-K and kindergarten spaces with the main school building. Reconstruction of the existing building included new roofing, masonry restoration, new wood window sashes, replacement of MEP systems and ADA improvements. Existing ornate stonework at an existing entrance was carefully removed and was resurrected to create an alternate entrance from the parking lot.
Buffalo Public School No. 65, Roosevelt Early Childhood Center, was built in 1922. Exterior scope of work included restoration, repointing, and cleaning of the masonry facade and stone trim. New wood window sashes were installed, and the existing built-up roof was replaced. Concrete walks and ramps were replaced, and the parking lot was repaved. The interior of the school was updated with the installation of new MEP systems, new finishes, and casework. ADA improvements include new accessible bathrooms and a new elevator to service all floors. The main office was reconfigured to provide enhanced visual access and security. At the rear of the school and adjacent to green space, an age-appropriate playground was created. School 65 accommodates grades pre-K through 4.
At the iconic School No. 198 International Preparatory School at Grover, Cleveland, reconstruction work included a sports entrance addition to allow direct access to the gym. A new corridor was created to improve circulation and address security concerns during class changes. The cafeteria and kitchen were relocated to allow for increased occupancy and the creation of new program spaces, including a new clinic area with exam rooms, a state-of-the-art home and careers room, 2 new art rooms and a dance studio. 6 new computer classrooms were added throughout the school. The existing library was upgraded to include all new computer workstations and a new librarian station and office. The existing elevator was demolished and a brand new ADA compliant elevator was installed. The auditorium was renovated, the stage floor was sanded and refinished, new seating installed, and new stage rigging, lighting, and sound systems were added. School 198 serves grades 5 through 12.
We feel our program initiatives brought us closer together. For example, the Buffalo Public Schools program featured an aggressive MWBE business utilization and workforce diversification plan. This plan comprised of two parts, a component that regulates the inclusion of minority-owned businesses and women-owned businesses, or MWBEs, and a component that promotes diversity within the building trades workforce. In an effort to encourage the growth of MWBE business utilization, the JSCB set a goal that 30% of subcontract work be performed by certified MWBE firms. 25% would go to minority firms and 5% would go to women firms. To ensure that minorities and women were employed by the building trades, the JSCB also established a goal of 30% workforce diversification. This meant 23% was minority participation and 7% was women participation.
Bevlar Associates Incorporated, Inclusion Development Associates Incorporated, and Compliance and Administrative Services of New York were retained as primary compliance monitors for the district-wide technology contract, energy performance contract, and all five construction phases. These firms monitored the contractors, consultants, suppliers, and others performing services. They also monitored workers on each project site. They verified by certified payroll the amounts paid to minorities and women that worked on the project in order to determine if the diversity goals were achieved. These reports were produced monthly and reported to the JSCB. We are proud to say that all phases have exceeded the diversity goals.
But we want those businesses that were grown through this process to stabilize themselves enough to keep it going.
Not only has Ciminelli provided enormous opportunities for minorities and or women-owned businesses, but, you know, there's almost $1 billion worth of projects going on in Buffalo and Western New York right now. And so if you are in business and you have a legitimate skill, and you, particularly if you have state certification, you are going to get a contract.
Many of the contractors who worked on this project started their businesses at the onset of the Buffalo Schools program. These contractors continue to flourish, and this alone proves the community outreach and MWBE development and mentorship works, and we wish those companies continued success. Here are just a few of our MWBE programs and MWBE contractor spotlights.
The Buffalo Public Schools program created new opportunities for Buffalo Public School students through a set of curriculum enrichment initiatives branded as LPCiminelli's Construction Connections. The JSCB, LPCiminelli, and our partners provided students with opportunities to experience the construction industry firsthand.
Our top program was TEAM. Now, TEAM stands for Technical Engineering Architectural Mentoring, and it focused on career exploration for high school students. This program provided students the opportunity to learn and network with industry professionals in architecture, construction, and engineering. Here are a few highlights from our premier program.
I like the TEAM program because I think it gives us an opportunity to come and just be involved in something else outside of school. And then I love the fact that it involves kids from all different schools. It's not just Buffalo Public Schools, but it's integrated with other schools. So I love that aspect of it. And I love the fact that it's a mentoring program, especially fields that we're interested in, like engineering and architecture. I'm here because I was interested. When the program was presented to me, I was kind of blown away, and I liked it, and I said I'll give it a shot, and I've liked it since I've been here.
It was great. I learned a lot from this program, and I will definitely use it in the future.
My name is Camille Shepherd. I am owner of That's That Construction. We are what you would consider a specialty contracting company. We specialize in plaster, traditional old school plaster, EFIS, and fireproofing.
What I brought today is something that we could use as a hands-on product. It's called Venetian plaster. This is our first time actually doing a hands-on. If you guys ain't scared to get your hands dirty.
What are the paths or directions one can take within architecture? For myself, I had a very different path becoming an architect.
The seed was planted in my head by my father, who was a civil engineer. My father recognized my interest in building because we had a wood shop in the basement. So I was one of his only children that really enjoyed building things and spending my weekends with a table saw and a drill press and welding and things of that nature.
We're excited to always come up to TEAM. We've participated with TEAM for a long time. We met some of our students from the TEAM program, and they're doing very well at Alfred State. You know, whether they're seniors graduating, freshmen coming in, what they're looking forward to. Most of them have had internships, most of them have had summer jobs, and you know, a little bit about their curriculum and hopefully their full-time employment when they do graduate.
My name is Miranda Pifus. I'm Ikea Jenkins. We're juniors at Alfred State in construction management. Tom actually came here and introduced himself, and that's how we learned about Alfred State College. So we're in the four-year program for construction management. We're doing well and we like it. TEAM was definitely like beneficial in learning what we wanted to do more. Being in carpentry, well, majoring there, we only learned one aspect, but TEAM definitely brought in like people like Tom or just business owners that really helped us decide where did we want to go in the field of construction. It helped us a lot. I was able to like get an internship through it, and it definitely taught me more of what I wanted to do career-wise.
It is always a pleasure to be in the presence of students who have their sights on higher heights. And by the parents and their encouragement and support, I thank you for the work that you do as well. And of course, I am especially indebted to the Ciminelli Company and its employees for the work and due diligence that they do toward our young people and motivating them to seek out professions and careers that deal with construction. I hope that all of you will remember that average is not enough.
I think you are absolutely tremendous, and I'm certain you know how fortunate you are and how proud your families are of you.
Partnering with our friends at the Western New York Construction Career Days has always been something we've looked forward to every year. Their annual event at the Operating Engineers Training Facility introduces high school students to the building trades and construction industries with hands-on activities. Students participate in bricklaying, welding, painting, carpentry, operating a backhoe, mini excavators, and skid steers. They also had the opportunity to speak with representatives from construction firms, unions, and colleges that offer construction programs. The Buffalo Schools Renovation Project presented more opportunities in the building trades for our students, and we wanted to make sure every Buffalo student was exposed to these hands-on experiences. With the help of the Buffalo Building Trades and the City of Buffalo, we created a smaller version of the Western New York Construction Career Days at the Buffalo Convention Center for students who were not able to attend the large event at the Operating Engineers Facility.
Buffalo Building Trades wants to increase their numbers, and so they wanted to do a trade fair to get kids interested, and not just have displays, but they wanted to have interactive displays as you see around. You got cranes going, you have welding going, you have forklifts going, you have a whole lot of hands-on opportunities to let the students see that what construction trades are really about. And so now they get the feeling and they see themselves doing the work and they're really enjoying it. And we look forward to continue this partnership to attract the students and show their progression through the apprenticeship opportunities that's afforded here. The president, Paul Brown, has been wonderful in putting this together. The convention center has been wonderful. LPCiminelli, which is really the heartbeat of this whole thing.
And the only people we invited were the Buffalo School seniors who normally don't get invited to the career days in October. And it's, to tell you the truth, it's been way past my expectations. They seem very interested. I went around to the different booths. They're signing up people for the apprenticeship, and this should be very successful. It's very important to the building trades because we're very community driven to keep trying to get as many people involved in the trades as possible. Most people try to encourage them to go to college, which is great. College is great, but some people are good with their hands. They're very, very skilled with their hands, and we want to make sure that we get every single one of them.
Over the past 10 years, we have engaged and educated our students through many Construction Connection programs. Our Mission Control McKinley High was another great program. Senior vocational students who attended McKinley during the renovation were treated to tours by our project manager, Vinnie Jowdy. Shop students even made shower covers for the lockers in their schools. They also learned from contractors about the work that was being performed in their school.
Now all these cross members that you see, a lot of them are going to be exposed. So architecturally, you're going to come into the classroom and you're going to see a steel member exposed. Those cross members help support that end of the building by bringing back the support further back into the building where we have columns and footers that go into the ground.
Partnering with the Buffalo Schools for their annual scholarship college and career fair is another highlight for the Construction Connection program that we continued even after the Buffalo Public Schools renovation project was complete.
We need our young people to find careers and futures right here in this city. Buffalo needs a reinvigoration. We have wonderful opportunities in the medical corridor. We have a community that's ready to rebuild itself, but we need these young people to go to college, get training and a career, and come back and live in these cities so that we can have our grandchildren nearby. Of all our collaborations, I have to say our work with Ciminelli has really been significant. We've known through this whole event that you were right here by our side, so I want to thank you as well. You're building our future in more ways than one.
Another excellent program under the Construction Connections umbrella was our paid summer management internship. This program opened the doors for our youth to experience the construction field in the business sense. Selected Buffalo High School seniors worked 8 weeks with various departments. Students had the opportunity to work alongside executives in the safety, estimating, accounting, marketing, and information technology departments. Our Construction Connection program encountered many students who had a strong desire to enter the engineering and architectural industry. We discovered these students through our team program, internships, one-day orientation, and our award-winning Discover Design program.
Welcome to Canon Design.
This is one of the projects right now currently is McKinley High School project, and it's on Elmwood Street. So I figured maybe it's a good way to show you guys how, as a designer, how we approach the design.
The program was focused on careers in architectural and engineering design. Students spent 1 week in an intensive boot camp that was created to give them a look into design-related fields and how their education would translate to the real world. The sessions included several tours of reputable architectural and engineering firms, a tour of the University of Buffalo School of Architecture and Planning, and Q&A sessions with industry professionals. On the final day, students presented what they learned to become eligible for scholarship dollars for the school of their choice. Our Discover Design top winner, Dylan Burns, is currently a junior at the University of Buffalo, working on his Bachelor of Science in Architecture and minoring in Environmental Design. We are very proud of Dylan and all of the students who participated in our programs. Here are just a few who were highlighted as LPCiminelli's Student Spotlight.
My experience with the LPCiminelli internship program was a great experience because I learned many things. For example, the different departments that they had, well, at least some of the departments. For example, the BIM department, which is basically a department that involves making models for presentations on the computer. So I never knew that they needed that.
I gained a lot of experience being at BPS 65. I was able to learn from the project manager and some of the construction workers would like give me advice while I'm walking by and like, you know, encourage me. I learned to read blueprints, which really came in handy my junior year, and you know, that's a big part of being in the field. I got to talk to, you know, a lot of people. I even met an architect. It was just really exciting. And I just, you know, got to be on a real construction site because people only see the end product. And I think what happens before that is really important.
As a McKinley student, I received an experience majoring in carpentry. Here in carpentry, we learn to do architectural drawings as well as performing and actually building each piece. We learned about OSHA codes as well and how to work machine tools. While interning at LPCiminelli, I gained plenty of experience. Interning in different departments definitely gave me a rift of what it takes to run a successful company. Being able to go on site and actually see and observe the different phases that it takes to go through a construction project was very, very rewarding.
The historic Buffalo Public Schools program has indeed been a successful public-private partnership. From initial planning to final delivery, the project raised the bar for excellence in program development. Our community can take pride in what has been accomplished. Before construction began, the district's facilities lacked many of the tools used in modern education. After a decade of work with five phases of construction completed, the positive change in infrastructure is evident throughout the district. Most importantly, the positive effect on students in these new learning environments is apparent.
We're seeing academic success, and we're tying the academic success with the new buildings, and we are making significant gains, especially in the early grades, which will bear fruit more and more. So we will see significantly higher graduation rates, which we all want to see as leaders in this community.
We know there's a direct correlation between student achievement and being in a school that has been renovated. Children don't want to be in a dungeon trying to learn. They want the atmosphere there. They want all of the instruments and tools that are necessary. And in these schools, you have state-of-the-art equipment, and that means an awful lot.
The way in which the new architecture has maintained and incorporated the historical significance of the old schools. So I think the schools represent, you know, so much more than a building.
Right.
You know, it really is a spirit. It's a history of a community, the history of a people.
Mm-hmm.
And I think that the ways in which the reconstruction has taken place, it maintains that history and helps us to build on it for these children.
This is a source of community pride, has been historically, is now, and will be moving forward. The addition of Terry Schutte as the new principal adds an added dimension to this, which is, I think, extraordinary and will bode well for the district itself, but for the community that will benefit from it. Terry has a track record and extraordinary work, 7 years at Southside Elementary School, turned that school around, and she's going to bring this place back to what it was. And it's a great facility. The Ciminelli Company did an extraordinary job as part of the school's reconstruction program, which is very comprehensive. But this almost $40 million project is going to give these kids the kind of environment that they need.
We'd like to thank our partner, the Buffalo School District, for their unwavering support during this renovation expansion. And I'd like to thank the subcontractors who were dedicated from day one to making this a huge success.
I want to thank LPCiminelli for doing a tremendous job in being the master developer of the renovation of our schools. As chairman of the board, on behalf of all of the other board members, I want to thank them for the tremendous work that LPCiminelli is doing in transforming Buffalo's public schools.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.